can't sleep safe at night. Game of Thrones. You think she'd like Game of Thrones? She'd be like, that wasn't true, I had that king and he wasn't like that. Outlander. Yeah. What do you think she'd do in her downtime? Watch Criminal Minds? Criminal Minds, really? That's it. I'm going to pinch your answer. Rowena likes to watch Criminal Minds in her downtime. And also The Handmaid's Tale, but that's just me. I can't stop watching that show. The problem is we're half living inside it, that's the problem.
Yeah.
Anyway. Hello.
Hi, I'm Jan, I'm from DeKalb, Illinois, and actually, what a coincidence, while we were in line, we were talking, and we figured out it was the last person in line's birthday today.
Oh.
And you gave me the best birthday gift, you took a selfie with me.
Oh.
And I absolutely love you, but I'm somebody with anxiety, and I know you really don't sing often, and I was just wondering, how do you face your fears like that?
You're really brave to ask that question. You just did it already yourself. Didn't you? You just did it anyway. That's what it is, isn't it? It's so awesome. It's so cool. You know the answer to that question. You just keep doing it. Even though you're petrified. Thank you, that's so kind of you to say that. I know I brought tears to my own mother's eyes when I used to sing when I was younger. She was the first person to tell me I was tone deaf. She's got a really good ear. That's so kind of you, thank you. Thank you. You know the answer. You've got it. You've all got it, you're all here. We're getting through the toiletries, you guys! Like two more. Hi.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Good. I'm Dwayne. I'm from Blake, Sarah, Michigan, so Shelby Township. If I don't say Detroit or 30 minutes from, everybody just gets confused.
Yeah.
I guess my question is, who's your favorite, besides yourself, fictional witch?
Huh. I used to read the books, The Worst Witch. Do you remember that? I love Bewitched. I used to spend a lot of time trying to figure out how to wiggle my nose. I love Meryl Streep's Into the Wood Switch. I love Jessica Lange. And we have the same birthday. Who's your favorite witch, apart from the one?
Oh, apart from you?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I know, there's no comparison. There's no...
I forgot her name. I didn't watch her much. The one with the angel. Husband.
Thank you. Okay, so that you're so sweet, I'm giving you squashy cotton wool balls. There you go. Thank you. Okay, we've only got one toilet to let. Oh, perfect timing, Norton. Look at you. Perfect timing. I've got one stolen good left to give away, so I can answer one more question. You guys, you're perfectly in time. Perfect timing.
Thank you.
You're known for it.
That's what I do.
What's your name, where you from, John?
My name is Candace, I'm from Victoria, Illinois, and I have a question. I want to know, as Marina, what was your most favorite spell to cast and why?
What was my most favorite spell to cast as Rowena, and why? The spell.
Did you give away all of your Pilford merchandise?
There's no evidence left.
Yeah, where is it? No, it's distributed amongst the innocent. And, very clever. It's product laundering. Ladies and gentlemen, you know her, you love her. You just helped facilitate her criminal activity. Rick Cavill! to have somebody come out on the stage who's going to do the jump, and we're not worried about their hip and knee health. It's so,
oh, to be young.
It's so weird.
I had the same thought.
Al thought that was funny that Al doesn't realize that his, that every move controls the band. Like, you know, he's freeforming over there, and he gives a kick, and Norton stops. So Norton again. Oh, sorry.
I didn't realize I had so much power until now.
You have a tremendous amount of power.
This is bad news for us. I'm still excited to do the jump. The jump's just exciting.
Let's do it again. Come on.
Let's do it again.
There we go. Let's press G.
It's just an incredible
thing. That actually hurt my knees.
Careful, please.
Al.
Yes, sir.
You getting to do anything in Chicago? I mean, yeah, I saw you over here in our neighborhood last night. Did you get out and about at all, see the city?
I did. I got to do a river tour, which was awesome.
Very cool.
I learned a lot about architecture.
Nice.
Awesome.
Modernism. That's it. And also we went to the Art Institute.
Okay. Oh, nice.
That was really cool. And I nearly died trying to eat a deep dish pizza.
Yeah.
Welcome to Chicago.
We realized, Pam and I realized, this is the first time we've been to Chicago and not had a deep dish pizza.
Oh, that's good. We look healthier, though. We feel...
Well, I think we all have a note from our doctor saying, do not have any deep pizza.
They're just like, yeah, I'm going to go to Chicago. The doctor's like, you know you can't, right?
You're not.
Just like, whatever, fine.
All right, I won't take up any more time. We love this guy. Ladies and gentlemen, Big Al Keller.
How you guys doing? Awesome. I couldn't decipher. Thank you very much. I'll knock that out right away. It's my birthday today. I share a birthday with Brianna Lee here. So that's pretty cool that we can be birthday buddies, you know? So, shout out your birthday buddies, that's pretty cool. Except she's releasing an album. I am not releasing an album. So, just to let you guys down right away, no album release for me. But I'm super happy to be here on this day. So, thank you guys for being here, I appreciate it. Usually I can see the audience a little better, but these lights are blinding, oh my god. It's like the sun, but... Oh my god. The flattery. Amazing. So thanks for having me, guys. And how many of you guys are from Chicago? Wisconsin? For you Wisconsin people, how attached you are to That 70s Show? Does it matter? Is it... Just out of curiosity. I had to know. All right, let's go for it.
Hi, I'm Ash.
Hi.
So I was wondering, if Jack is technically part angel, could he hypothetically switch vessels, or would that not be possible due to his human part?
Well, I'm going to say that's going to be not possible, solely based on me wanting to play the part. At this point... I can't afford for Jack just to be switching bodies. I think he can only be me. I don't know if that's in the Wikipedia yet, but I'm gonna throw that out there right now. It's crazy, just the characters, like right now, like Dean Michael. It's really funny in the script, because it'll be like, Dean Michael, and we're like, Dean, is it Michael? So I'm gonna say no, I'm gonna shoot it down. Thank you, though. Hi.
Hi, I'm Jordan.
Hi, Jordan.
I was hoping you could settle a debate that me and my mom were having during the season.
Okay, I don't want to get involved in family squabbles. I'll do my best, though.
Okay, short version. My mom loves you and thinks you're an awesome character. I'm still kind of on the fence and think you might go dark side. Is that possible at all?
I definitely think that, first of all, shout out your mom. I think the characters, the dangerous part about Jack is that he is the son of Lucifer, so there's definitely a possibility that it can all go south at any moment. And I think that was definitely what was driving Dean last year. I don't know. I think that Jack just has just that little thing in him where he's definitely capable of going to the dark side. I hope he doesn't, but you know, I mean, hold on. We'll see. You know, that doesn't really settle the debate. I'm gonna go with Jack being good forever. Thanks.
Love you, Alex.
Thank you.
Hi.
So
I was just wondering, like, through the time you've been working on the set, what has been your favorite fail that you've either witnessed or accidentally done?
My favorite fail. I have to think about that one. You know, sometimes you forget lines. Sometimes you just say the lines wrong. Those aren't hilarious fails, but safety on set is kind of like an important thing. So no one's like fallen off a cliff or like tripped over a camera. You know, pretty safe. In terms of fails, I think mostly it would just be probably me being like hard on myself, you know? And be like, ugh, we need to do that take again, you know? Yeah. Not a hilarious answer, my bad. Hello.
Hi, I'm Terry. I have a question. I follow Lord Tyrion on Instagram. So my question is, where is he today?
Lord Tyrion is currently ruling the kingdom. Back in the apartment. Who knows what he's done in our absence. So I did say this at the meet and greet earlier, but if you guys would like, we'll take a poll. There is a Lord Tyrion story that I can share. I'll take that as a yes. For the rest of you guys, sorry. So Tyri, despite his majestic life, somehow manages to almost end his life every year. So I don't know if your guys' animals do this, but you know, he'll get a lung infection, or in one case he jumped off an 8-story balcony to the ground and nearly died. He's alive, it's okay. More recently, Jenna pulled how long? Like this much string out of him because he ate it.
Oh.
So most recently, this past week, I picked him up and he kind of made like a little noise. He went like, I'm like, oh God, no. What has this cat done now? And then I did it again to be sure. And he's like, I'm like, oh no. Like we're gonna have to gonna rush to the vet. Like we gotta go, it's an emergency. But he's fine, he's purring. Whatever. So we wake up in the morning, and then on the couch, you know, as a gift, I think he decided, so he puked up the treats that I gave him last night, but he also puked up a large feather, probably about the size of his body. So that is life with the Lord, Tyrion.
Aww.
TMI?
No.
Okay, cool. Hi.
Hi. I'm Megan.
What up, Megan?
In the season finale, when Lucifer is trying to make Sam or Jack like kill each other, after Sam picks up the blade, was Jack afraid of Sam killing him in that moment, or was he okay with it? Did he trust him?
I mean, he definitely has a huge trust for Sam. I think Jack was just so petrified at the circumstances. And also having his father turn on him like that, I think he was just going through so much, it was just really traumatic. He definitely has a huge trust in Sam, I think, you know, obviously they have a good dynamic. Just what Sam would do, because Sam's kind of the guy who will fall on his own sword, you know, to protect everyone. So I think he was unsure, but it's just a terrible situation for your father to put you in, you know? Yeah. Hey.
Hi, Alex. My name is Hannah. First of all, I just wanted to say happy birthday.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And second of all, what's it like working with Jensen and Jared?
I love this question. I can take it anywhere. It's terrible. It's terrible, guys. Don't do it. Don't be nice to them. It's not worth it. No, it's been great. Everyone's really welcoming. It's a really warm set, good energy. You know, minus all the trauma from the pranks. Other than that, it's a pretty good life, you know?
Thank you.
Yeah. What do you guys want me to be like? He's like, yeah, they're topless all the time. Mud wrestling. There's like Jello Wrestling Thursdays, like mandatory for all Supernatural cast.
Woo! I need that tape.
We need that tape.
Yes.
If you guys see Old School, then you know what I'm talking about. Hi.
Hi. I'm Danielle, and we all know that the boys prank you and Misha a lot. So I was wondering if you two were gonna like form an alliance and prank them back, maybe?
Well, the terrible part is that I was supposed to be Misha 2.0, and I thought with that name that I would have Misha protecting me, guiding me, being on my team, at least. You know, Team Free Will, Misha 2.0, I felt a lot of unity in those names. There is not unity in those names. Unfortunately, it became almost like a wrestling tag team for them, you know? I'd laugh and then Jared would come out, boom, Jensen comes in, and I'm like, come on, Misha, don't put me up against the ropes. But what does Misha do? Boom, he tags in. One of them's holding me down. Other one's punching me in the gut. So, you know. Thanks, Misha. Thank you. Hello.
Hi, I'm Caitlin.
Hi.
Hi, so I was wondering, did I have to read this? I'm so nervous. What was it like?
Take a breath. You're all good.
What was it like when you first joined Supernatural? Were you being pranked immediately, or like, did it take a while?
Well, they were very professional for the first couple days. Which is always great if you guys get a new job. You know, you really want to set the bar high just so it can get crushed later on. So initially, really good. But, you know, now we're down, you know, in the mud, if you will.
Jell-O.
Not the Jell-O, guys. I already, certain things you regret. You're like, ah, no, I shouldn't have said that. But yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, no worries. Hey.
Hi, I'm Krista.
Hello.
So my sister and I, okay, well, I have a question, and okay. Also my sister and I made you a card for your birthday.
Thank you.
And I was wondering if I could give it to you, or you could.
Sure.
Thank you.
Does it say anything crazy or offensive?
I don't think so.
Okay. Can I read it out loud?
I guess so.
Don't worry, I won't read it out loud. I won't do that to you. P.S. Tell your girlfriend to say hi, and she's an awesome photographer.
Aww.
That's very nice of you.
Okay, and so my question is, which one of the boys does Jack consider most like his father, or like someone who cares for him most?
It's tough to say. Again, more reverently, like they're kind of like a tag team father thing at this point. There's definitely the kind of celestial connection with Castiel, but at this point, you know, I think they're all kind of on the level for, you know, My Three Dads, the sitcom.
You need a spin-off.
Yeah, I'm gonna give them equal playing field at this point. Thank you for the card. Hello.
Hello, my name is Nikila. Happy birthday again.
Thank you.
It's a good place to be. So I was wondering, what characteristics do you have in common with Jack, and what's completely different between you two?
What I like about him is that he is very optimistic. I like that he sees the world with like fresh eyes a lot of the time, that he hopefully sees the good in most everyone. So I think when I'm having like a good day, I feel like that. So I think that part definitely resonates with me, but I mean, he's so optimistic though. You know, I'm not as optimistic as he is. But again, I think on a good day, there's like a lot of similarities that way. You know?
Thank you.
Thanks. What up, Cass?
Hi.
Hey.
My name is Melody. And you're my favorite actor. I want to say that real quick.
Wow, thank you.
And my question is, does Jack know about the sexual tension between Dean and Castiel?
Sorry, what was the last thing he said?
And how do you think he reacts to it?
Oh!
You guys are very, it's always very, like, yes or no on these ones. I think the sexual tension you're seeing is brotherhood. But again, you know what? We're all having our own human experience, and I definitely think you would like to see your own version of My Sweet Dad's a sitcom. I would be the comedic relief, and again, on your show, I'm guessing there's topless bull riding and such. You know? I think Jack, what actually I like about the character is that he is so, the idea of like sexuality for him, and even seeing that is so beyond where he's at. Which is great. So he's just more focused on, like, you know, trying to save his friends, as opposed to like, what's that sexual tension over there? Over there in the corner there. All right, thank you. Hello.
Hi, my name is Emily, and I was wondering, what do you think Jack's favorite TV show is, and why?
I mean, obviously, this is going to have a skewed response, but I'm going to say his favorite show at this point is Scooby-Doo. And if it would have been possible for Jack to see a Scooby-Doo Supernatural crossover episode, can't wait to see how the person signing that does a crossover episode thing. Very cool. That, I think, would be cool. They did kind of tie it in at the beginning of the season where they had Jack watching cartoons. So I'm going to say Scooby-Doo. Which character do you think he would like best? Shaggy? Scooby?
I think he'd like Scooby best.
Yeah. What about Shaggy the Stoner? Would that work for him or not?
Maybe.
You watch these shows as a kid, and you're just like, they're just hungry all the time. And then you're older, and you're like, these writers, they were, this is a different time. Hi. Hi, Christina.
So first, just real quick, I do want to tell you that from the moment I saw you in the first episode, I fell in love with Jack as a character and with you as an actor.
Oh, thank you.
And then my question is, Jack is, what, maybe a couple months old at the most, and I just want to know if you would want any sort of, like, I guess, experience for him to be like a child instead of trying to save everyone as he's trying to do. Like, would you like to see that in season 14?
Yeah, I mean, I think that's kind of the struggle for Jack's character is that, you know, there's parts of him that I think would really love to be a kid or just have a moment of just innocence. But especially with Jack kind of being, when he got thrust into Apocalypse World and then kind of dealing with Michael and then, you know, meeting Jim Beaver's character and all those kind of people, he was really forced into a role of, like, you know, protector, gotta do the right thing, gotta protect these people. It's not like he's had time to play kickball, you know, or whatever it is that kids do now, you know? There's, like, little moments where he, like, gets to enjoy Star Wars, and I think those are, like, really nice moments for him, but obviously he's been thrust into, like, a really important position that, you know, obviously he didn't get asked to do, it just happened, you know?
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Hi, hello. I'm Betsy. So my question is, a lot of the castmates have been saying, you know, they're getting older, they take naps more instead of day drinking. So my question is, how does it feel to be the one of the younger members of a really old cast?
Are you gonna ask them to sit their panel?
I could if you want.
That must be crushing. How do you respond to that? Hey, how does it feel to be old? You're like, I don't know, kind of sucks. I don't know. I feel young, but at the same time, like, I'm getting older as well. So, you know, I think they were living, like, a little fast and loose in, like, the first, like, 5-6 seasons, you know? No wife, you know? No children. They probably had a lot of time to do this stuff. But you just can't party like that anymore, you know? I can't, at least. I don't know about you guys. Have you guys been out this weekend? Is that like, are there like supernatural ragers after? So like everyone back in my hotel room. But that being said, it's always nice to have older friends, because guess what? You're always gonna be younger than them. And you can always stick it to them. So as a young person, make some old friends, they'll probably make you better. And as an older person, make some young friends, because they'll keep you young.
Kidding.
Thanks.
Hi, Alex.
Hi.
First of all, happy birthday.
Thank you.
Glad you're here with us. And we're always excited to have Jack join the cast. So my question is, before you auditioned for Supernatural, were you aware of Supernatural? And did you know what you were getting into?
I definitely didn't know what I was getting into, per se. I'm from Vancouver, so you see like the filming locations kind of scattered around the city. And because it is a show that shoots there, you end up reading for the show, and you know like Arrow shoots there, Flash shoots there, like Legends of Tomorrow shoots there. So there's all these shows that are around, so you kind of have an awareness of them. Did I think, you know, getting this part would land me here in front of all you guys? Definitely not. Just kind of a fun bonus. So you really don't know what you're getting into until it's kind of already in motion, which is kind of crazy. It was like the first one I went to was in San Francisco, and they're like, yeah, it'll be good. I'm like, what do I expect? They're just like, you know? Yeah, thank you.
Hi.
Hello.
My question is about Alec. I'm sorry, I'm nervous.
Okay.
About your character. He's not really had a chance to be a kid and be innocent, like you were saying. And he's been through a lot of trauma, but he obviously likes that kid stuff. Like, he loves candy, he loves Star Wars. Is he gonna get a chance to, like, kick back in the next season and maybe binge watch some Netflix, eat candy?
Some Netflix and chill. Or for Jack, Netflix and candy. I don't think so. I don't think the show works like that. Pretty much any time they do anything, as soon as it looks like anybody can relax, something terrible happens. At least in my experience that I've seen. It's just like there's no really time off for them as hunters, you know? It kind of seems like the job just keeps going. Also, would you guys watch an episode of a dude just watching Netflix? How boring would that be? I don't see these characters get any downtime. Again, there's the like crossover. People are like, what would be your crossover? And people are like, Hawaii 5-0. Because everyone's like, let's shoot Supernatural in Hawaii. So that would be awesome. You know, maybe some Hawaii shirts, maybe some board shorts. Maybe they, you know, have to catch a vampire who surfs. I don't know. But I'm down as long as we're filming in Hawaii. Thanks. Hello.
Hi. My name's...
Uh-oh. Let's try that again.
I want to know, what's your favorite and least favorite thing about your cat?
Least favorite? That's like a biased question. My favorite thing is that he likes me more than he likes Jenna. Which is super selfish. But you know when cats pick you and it just like feels good? You're like, yeah, the guy chose me. My least favorite, it's not even least favorite. What he'll do is he'll try to like break into things. Like he'll try to like rip apart open treat bags, which I just find hilarious. So I can't even get mad. I just encourage him. I'm like, you did real good today, buddy. I'm actually just like, I watch him do like destructive things and you just end up being proud. You know? You're just like, ah, man, you worked all night to open that bag. Like, good for you, little guy. So I can't hate the cat. You know. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Lindsay. First of all,
Lindsay.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
My question would be, what is the worst prank that Jared and Jensen have pulled on you since you've joined the cast?
I mean, I guess that's up for debate. A worst prank. You know what? They haven't, like, filled my car with anything. You know, they haven't, like, abandoned me at a location or something.
Yet.
That's true. That's very true. I doubt they're backstage, like, writing notes, though. It's like, has fear of being abandoned. Like, yes. Check. I think the funniest one for me was the dicks. They're just like, they were giving me the video of my mom who sent me this beautiful message about how Jack's gonna be fine, whatever, and open it up and just a bunch of penises. I thought that was like, that one took the most planning. It took a little bit of like deception and dedication. You know, we had to coordinate with the IT guy to make sure that there were enough dicks to fill up the screen. So really, you just gotta respect the game at that point. You could be angry, but instead you should just be thankful that they want to mess with you that badly, that they're willing to sacrifice time out of their day. You know, so you gotta appreciate it. You know.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thanks. Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Liam from Minnesota, and I'm wondering if you could have an animal companion for Jack. Who would it be?
Well, thanks for coming from Minnesota. Go Vikings. I think it'd be cool, maybe this is just what I would want, but it'd be super cool if Jack had like a wolf.
Yeah.
I think wolves are pretty cool, and then you see the Game of Thrones stuff. I mean, you probably have you watched Game of Thrones? Good for your parents. I think you got a few, how old are you?
11.
Yeah, you got a couple more years, right? But I'd say a wolf would be pretty cool. I could hang out with the wolf. The wolf and I could go on wolf adventures. I think this has potential. What do you think? Yeah? If you could give Jack an animal, what would you pick? Boom, he said wolf. Wolf? Yeah, we're on the same page. Thank you. Oh my goodness. Hello.
My name is Jordan, and my question is how do you change your eye color?
Aww.
Well, thanks for coming. Hello.
Hi.
Hi. How do I say this without disappointing you? At this point, the only way for me to change my eye color is purely through Jack magic. So the power of Jack. Thanks for your question.
Thank you.
Bye. So cute, jeez. I need to stop swearing in these panels. Just realize now, like, okay. Now my parents have to explain things on the ride home. Be like, Jack didn't mean it. Jack had a slip up. Hello.
Hi. If you created an episode, what would it be about?
Again, Hawaii, guys. We're going to Hawaii, 100%. any excuse for me. I was talking to the question and answer panel earlier, the private panel, and I really liked The French Mistake, and I really liked how just meta and hilarious it was. Just how, what I like about the show is it can kind of play on itself, make fun of itself, and the people on the show can make fun of themselves as well, which is not something every actor is capable of, for sure. I would definitely, okay, so here's my pitch then. So we're in Hawaii, but we're playing versions of ourselves. So Misha's tweeting constantly. Jared and Jensen aren't friends in real life. And then, I don't know, I think the like the meta version of Jack. Jack would be like a hardcore smoker or something. whatever, man. Roll the tape. And then we're in Hawaii doing our meta episode, trying to solve the surfing vampire crime. That's my idea at this point.
That's awesome.
You guys are like, this does not have traction. Please don't make this episode. Uh-huh. Or we could just do the Netflix and candy episode. In Hawaii. Hello.
Hello, my name's Maureen, and I'm from the city of the Hummers. And my question is, I'm so sorry, I'm so nervous.
It's okay.
What's it feels like being part of Supernatural? Did you watch some episodes and makes you want to join with the cast?
Sorry, what's the most exciting part?
What inspired you to join the cast of Supernatural? Did you watch some of the episodes and make you want to join the party?
Oh, okay. Like, I was inspired to join. So I have some sad news from the acting world. If you get a job, it's like a good thing. Like, you don't get to pick the job. I wish I could just like turn on TV and be like, I'd love to be on that show. And then just boom, I'm on the show. I'd go back, I'd take Jesse's part in Breaking Bad, you know? Just immediately. I guess it's been kind of a more of a luck thing for me. That lucky I was enough to get on the show, lucky enough to like have the part, and then lucky enough to kind of have these kind of experiences as like a bonus. So I guess, I've said this before, but like the most inspiring part of the job for me has been I get to meet you guys, which is awesome, and then even better is I see how you guys support each other. I see, like today, one of the women in the panel, or the panel in the question, she got a matching tattoo with her friend of the coordinates of where they like met during like a Supernatural convention they went to together. So like, that is crazy inspiring, or like what you guys do for charity, how you guys support each other, and you know, Brianna's got an album coming out. So like, none of that happens without this. So that would be what's inspiring to me. Thanks. Sorry, that was a little long-winded. I'll go back to Hawaii jokes. Hello.
So I'm asking on behalf of my friend. She couldn't be here. It's her birthday today.
This is a sneaky one. When you know, when like you're in grade school, you're like, my friend says that.
No, but it's her birthday today too.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, and she was wondering if you pay attention to your zodiac sign at all.
Like the Zodiac killer? What's your friend's name?
Her name is Dexter.
Sorry, what?
Her name is Dexter.
Dexter?
Yeah.
What a cool name.
I know.
Wow. Wish I had a cool name. Happy birthday, Dexter. Shout out my new birthday buddy. Yes, I do a little bit. Not so much that I want to admit. Do you pay attention? Do you find it like sneakily accurate sometimes?
Yeah.
It's a little bit scary. I don't want you guys to like now look at the Zodiac thing and then be like, this is what Alex is dealing with today. There are some rain showers out there. So I do look. Jenna definitely looks. So I'll say that. Yeah. Happy birthday, Dexter. Is she here?
She's not in the country. She's in Mexico.
Ah, shout out Mexico.
Hello.
Hi, my name is Ryan, and I'm wondering how your life has changed as a result of being a part of Supernatural.
Zero changes. There are, I don't work at a bar, so that's pretty cool. I'm not bussing tables, which is also cool. Those are big deals for me. The level of support, the activity around, the travel, I mean, it's pretty crazy. I don't know. How has Supernatural changed your life? Yeah, buddy, you.
I've been following all the seasons through a bunch of random life changes, and I don't know, it's cool to have a constant show that's pretty good.
Yeah, that's thank you for saying that. It's, for me, I just wanted to honor that kind of when I'm going into the show. I know the show's been through so much with so many people, and I think that's kind of awesome that every week, or, you know, hopefully every week, that, like, you turn on TV and Sam and Dean are there kicking ass, and that, like, feels good. So I'm happy to hear that. Thank you. And Jack kicking, like, a little bit of ass. But, sorry, Mom. Damn it. Hi.
Hi. My name's Alex as well. And
boom.
Right? And it's also my birthday, so.
You're kidding!
No.
What?
So many birthdays.
You're lying.
No.
What a great lie you're doing right now. You for real?
Yeah.
What year were you born?
96.
Okay, well, we're not, you know. But still, that's crazy.
My question is,
what a day.
My mom wanted to know if...
This is another sneaky question. You ask questions for your mom. Okay. Mom, I see you. Like, what are you doing here? All right. Like, okay, go ahead.
I don't know if you remember Jesse, the half-demon, half-human child. I was wondering if you think there's going to be any connection between Jack and him, like maybe a rivalry, or maybe bring him back and help him, like, live the life you've learned to live as a half-angel?
I mean, I don't write the show. Spoiler. I don't write the show. I think, actually, we kind of saw this with Kaya's character. Not that she was, you know, half-angel, half-whatever. But Jack, I think, is very nurturing, and he would definitely want to help, you know, anybody who's kind of dealing with that. So I think he would definitely be nurturing and would be down to help, you know? Thank you, Mom. A lot of mom shout-outs today. It's good. Hi.
Hey, buddy.
Hello.
My question is, like, if you had the perfect opportunity to prank Jensen and Jared, how would you prank them?
I can't reveal that. This is years of planning. What are you talking about? Here's the thing. I am taking suggestions. So if you guys would like to Twitter me, please at me and tell me things like good suggestions, because I need to just like develop these as much as I can. So if you have one right now, I'm very down to do this.
No.
Come on. Hi.
Hi. My question is, in the episode where Jack is learning about his powers and starts harming himself and heals instantly, what impact does that have on you as Jack and as a person?
Me as Jack, or like Jack the person? What do you mean?
Like, what you had to like prep as, like.
Oh. Oh, like as like for me, what I had to prep as.
Yeah, like, did it have a down effect on you, or because it's like basically depression?
Yeah, I mean, it was definitely, there are certain scenes that are, like, easier to shoot than others. You know, one day you're eating 8 Mars bars in one take, and then the next day you're, like, stabbing yourself and, like, crying. So, like, there's a lot of varying things that go on. I definitely related to it in terms of, like, how he isn't happy with himself, he isn't, like, you know, happy where he's at. So there's definitely things that you kind of bring into that from your own personal life that are sometimes harder than others, you know, on the day. That stuff is hard. Just because you're like, you're saying it, you're doing an action, like you still feel it in some way. So that was definitely a difficult day. But what's great about that show and how the arc of Jack's character is gone, just having that acceptance from his family, from the Winchesters, from Castiel, kind of really helped him become what he was and just be okay with that. So I was happy that he had that low, but only so that he could kind of, you know, feel better about it down the road. You know?
Thank you.
Hello.
Hi, my name's Maddie.
Hi.
I was wondering, out of the whole cast, who do you think is the best dressed?
Again, it's always these questions that I feel like will get me in trouble later. Who's the best? Okay, well, I'd rather take a poll. Who's the most stylish? If it's, okay, ready? Will you guys help me? Okay. Is it, are we talking characters or are we talking like the actors?
Actors.
Okay, boom. Ready? Jensen. Jared. Misha. Mark. Yeah, Brianna, okay. Okay, definitely, I think it's gotta be definitely one of the girls. I'll call it tie based on that, but if you had to pick, who do you think is most stylish?
Probably Mark Shepard.
I feel like that guy was in suits. I feel like he was in suits for a lot of it. That's cool. Last question, speed round, go!
Hi, sorry. Okay. Maybe inappropriate to ask with a baby, but filming naked the first day that you're on set?
This is like mom's gotta get it in weekend, I feel like. You know, there are moments that are easier than others, but, you know, standing near naked in front of, new friends is always nerve-wracking. Yeah, thankfully that was the day that they were professional, because I feel like if this happened now, I'd get a lot more comments, a lot more jokes, you know, a lot more sideways glances, you know?
I like the way you said that was the day, not one of the days. That was the day.
Well, Rich, you know, in terms of being professional, it's one day at a time.
It is one day at a time. It's one day every 14 seasons, I think, is actually.
I love when they meet people and they like shake their hand for the first time and they're like, oh, it's so lovely to meet you, blah, blah, blah. And I'm just like, I know these assholes, what are they doing? Terrible.
Don't trust them! You're back there screaming.
Yeah.
Help! Don't look them in the eye! How was your time with the good people of Chicago?
I don't know, how was it?
You know him, you love him. That's Big Al Kilmer.
Thank you.
By the way, round of applause for Alex's girlfriend, Jenna.